President Lyndon Johnson said this about the war on poverty.
We want to open the gates to opportunity.
That was in 1964 when he created the federal program to help the poor. Today, former Brooklyn City Councilman and community activist Charles Barron says the initiative didn't work.
50 years later, we have some of the highest poverty in the richest country and the richest city in the world. 27.4% of the black community is impoverished.
Reverend Herbert Daughtry of the House of the Lord Church in downtown Brooklyn has a different take. He says 50 years ago, he led a group called Youth in Action that was a recipient of some of the federal money.
I would think that there are many people who receive their education as a result of the program, housing. In many ways, it helped. I mean, it didn't kill the enemy, but it wounded.
Both Daughtry and Barron say the issue of poverty is tied into the civil rights movement.
We realize that a part of the racism was directly related to the conditions of the people.
Martin Luther King didn't just have a dream. He had a radical vision. In 1968, he was launching the Poor People's Campaign, including everybody. Poor Latinos, poor Asians, poor whites, certainly poor blacks. He was fighting poverty. He was fighting against capitalism and its greed and its structural unemployment.
King was killed that year, never realizing that vision. Barron says it's up to black leaders today to make a local impact. In Brooklyn, there are currently 19 black elected officials.
We can have 17, 18, 19 black elected officials in Brooklyn. Well, what would that mean for East New York? And the poverty in East New York, the unemployment in East New York.
Both Barron and Daughtry say success in the ongoing war on poverty will ultimately be measured by how the masses of black people are doing. In Brooklyn, Janine Ramirez, New York One.